Today we will discuss anterior rhinoscopy with the help of thoracic nasal speculum. Anterior rhinoscopy is performed without nasal speculum and with nasal speculum. So in OPDs, thoracic nasal speculum is used to perform anterior rhinoscopy. Okay, now I will tell you how to hold the thoracic nasal speculum. What is the method of holding it? How you will insert the thoracic nasal speculum inside the nose of the patient, and how you will withdraw this speculum. Okay, so this is thoracic nasal speculum. You see, it is made up of steel and it has two prongs. Both prongs should be directed towards the patient. Okay, and we are the examiner, so our index finger will be inserted in this nasal speculum like this, so that this thoracic nasal speculum will be hanged in our index finger. Mind you, left hand is used to perform anterior rhinoscopy. Okay, after inserting this index finger, you will use the flexor surface of your middle finger and you will apply pressure of the flexor surface of your middle finger over the shaft of this thoracic nasal speculum, and the extensor surface of your ring finger would be resting on the other part of this thoracic nasal speculum, and with the help of our thumb we will stabilize this thoracic nasal speculum from the top like this. Okay, this how you will hold the thoracic nasal speculum, and then while you will insert this speculum in the nose of the patient, it should be closed like this. See, it should be closed like this. With the help of two fingers, that is ring finger and middle finger, we will apply pressure over the thoracic nasal speculum, and then we will insert this thoracic nasal speculum inside the nose of the patient like this. After entering into the nose of the patient, we will release pressure of our two fingers, that is ring finger and middle finger, so that the thoracic nasal speculum will be opened up. While this will be opened up, the nostril of the patient or the nasal cavity of the patient would be retracted, and you will look into the nasal cavity of the patient with a great ease, and all the structures of the nasal cavity would be appreciated in a good detail. Briefly, I will tell you what structures you will examine during your anterior rhinoscopy examination. The structures you will examine would be medial wall, lateral wall of the nose, roof and floor of the nose, vibrissae, turbinates, any discharge. You will also perform probe test during this anterior rhinoscopy test. On the medial wall, you will appreciate the nasal septum for any perforation, deviation, crusting, polypus, perforation, hematoma, abscess and things like that. And the lateral wall of the nose would be examined for the presence of inferior turbinates, sometimes middle turbinate. Okay. After examining the medial and lateral wall, floor and roof, you will examine the nasal cavity proper in detail. You will see the nasal cavity for any crusts, for any foreign bodies, for any abnormal discharge, any mass, any nasal polyp, and in case if there is any secretion is present in the nose of the patient, you will take Jobson's ear probe and apply cotton wool over it, and then with the help of thoracic nasal speculum you will insert this Jobson's ear probe in the nose of the patient, and then you will take the secretions out from the nasal cavity of the patient, and you will examine whole secretion for its color, foul smelling, blood staining and other features. Okay, so I hope you would have understood anterior rhinoscopy with the help of thoracic nasal speculum. Thank you very much.